Incredible!
A record-breaking amount of goals.
Gross!
Some that just take your breath away.
That is of the very highest order.
Unforgettable matches filled with drama.
Oh, would you believe it?
New managers making their mark. And some of the very best players in the world providing us, the fans, with so many thrilling out-of-your-seat moments.
Oh my goodness!
With the season getting past the halfway point, we will be taking a deep dive into how the table is shaping up and the fortunes of every club as we enter the second half of this intriguing Premier League campaign.
John McGinn, 1-0 Villa! What a goal!
Liverpool are sitting pretty at the top of the table. An incredible feat after having to rebuild in the summer. New signings Alexis McAllister, Dominic Szoboszlai, Ryan Gravenberch and Wataru Endo have transformed their midfield.
Individually, the quality of the boys is really good. Potential is outstanding. Attitude good, so means good chance for quality. The group is open for new things. We called it a new start. This is year one for this team.
The Reds are on a fantastic run of form, unbeaten in 14 matches after a 4-0 win against Bournemouth.
Gomez! Darwin Nunez at the double as well!
Liverpool now 52 matches unbeaten at Anfield in the league after what was a scintillating display against Newcastle.
Jota! Put in by Jones!
And with their never-say-die attitude, they've scored 19 points from losing positions. Liverpool 2.0 have every chance of securing a second Premier League title. Maybe Klopp will find that silverware slightly easier to come by. Surprise package Aston Villa are still very much in the hunt, sitting just 5 points behind the leaders. Unai Emery has been a revelation since taking over the hot seat. His side have won 26 Premier League games in 2023, the most in a calendar year in Villa's history.
Bailey deflected, it is! Villa do have the goal that really they do deserve.
And despite letting a two-goal lead at Old Trafford slip and just about coming away with a point at Villa Park to Sheffield United.
Into a lovely area and there's the equaliser. Nicolo Zaniolo.
Villa have won more games and earned more points at home than any other side in 2023. And with Ollie Watkins, whose 32 Premier League goal contributions in 2023 were the third highest in the competition, Emery's side have the firepower to threaten all the teams at the top, despite his insistence that Villa are still outsiders in the title race.
We are no contender, because maybe today you are not asking me about we are contender to win the title. We are not contender, but 2 weeks ago we were contender, and my response was the same like now. We are doing fantastic and brilliant first part of the season, but we want to keep it and we want more.
And whilst Emery may be playing down Villa's Premier League title chances, fans of Pep Guardiola's Manchester City will surely be feeling more confident. The newly crowned World Club champions are now unbeaten in five, with Phil Foden finding some form with 3 assists and a goal in his last 4 outings. On paper, it has looked like a stuttering first half of the season at times, but they're now only 5 points off the top with a game in hand after coming back to beat Newcastle 3-2 last time out.
That is a glorious goal!
And after 5 months out...
Well, that's what it means to these Manchester City fans to see him back.
It marked the return of a rather key player.
And marks his return to the Premier League stage. De Bruyne, what a ball towards Bob. And Oscar Bob tucks it in.
Level on points with City are Arsenal, who, like Arteta's former employers, have had stuttering periods of form.
Emerson getting it in just too far ahead of Bowen, and then Bowen pulling it back, and Sochek rifles it in!
December was a tricky time for the Gunners, having started the month at the top of the table, and goals were proving hard to come by with just 4 and 5. That was until a late flurry against Crystal Palace. where they secured a confidence-boosting 5-0 win.
Seeking the grand finale, which Gabriel Martinelli supplies.
Including a swift counter-attack with Leandro Trossard scoring in just 10 seconds from David Raya's throw.
Trossard with him, lovely ball. Trossard, cool as you like, 3-0 Arsenal.
And on the plus side, they have the second best defensive record this season, with William Saliba in particular establishing himself as one of the best defenders in the Premier League.
Grace under pressure personified, isn't he, Saliba?
Ooh, Saliba Haaland. What a battle that was.
Now Haaland goes down off the ball.
Moving slightly further north in the capital, Tottenham Hotspur have had an exciting campaign so far, with Ange Ball providing plenty of thrilling moments.
His first Tottenham goal.
$45 million bargain, pound bargain. I don't know what world you live in, mate, but...
Son is in, it's 2-2, wow. Here's Lo Celso, that's really good!
Postecoglou has had to deal with a multitude of injuries to key personnel, but Spurs have still managed to come out the hectic December schedule with 3 wins from 4, a return to the sort of form that saw them top the table early in the season. After enduring a difficult start to the campaign on and off the pitch, Richarlison has been in fine form recently with 6 goals in his last 6 matches.
What a superb goal from Spurs!
And he'll be looking to continue holding down the fort alongside new recruit Timo Werner, whilst club captain Son Heung-min is away at the Asia Cup. If Spurs can continue their form and proficiency in front of goal, they've scored in each of their last 33 Premier League matches, the longest ongoing streak in the competition, then they'll have every chance of securing a European spot come the end of the season. Over in East London, West Ham are quietly having a great season and are just 5 points behind Spurs in 6th place. It's a remarkable contrast to this time last season, when the Hammers were just 1 point above the relegation zone. Jarrod Bowen has been a bright spark in particular, with 11 goals and 2 assists. Already a great return than last season.
Here's Jarrod Bowen! What a way to start the season for West Ham!
They've now lost just once in their last 10 Premier League matches and kept 4 consecutive clean sheets in a row over the festive period, the joint most in the league all season. Wins against Manchester United and Wolves.
Akulis might be able to take full advantage. He can!
Were followed by David Moyes' first ever managerial win away at Arsenal.
David Moyes' maiden victory on this ground is a stunning result for West Ham United.
Obviously, Arsenal played incredibly well, put us under so much pressure. But we have to say that there's a big part of football which is defending, and sometimes you don't want to talk too much about it, but we done a really good job. Arsenal used to make a living out here, if you remember, so tonight we done a really good job in stopping them.
Another team who have had a superb turnaround in form since this time last year is Bournemouth. Andoni Iraola has helped turn the Cherries into a mid-table side, all the more impressive considering they failed to win any of their opening 9 matches. They've now lost just 2 of their last 9, a run that included a memorable victory at Old Trafford.
Oh, it's a lovely flick from Dominic Solanke!
And a 3-0 win at home to Fulham, where Iraola was serving a touchline ban.
I prefer to be on the bench, obviously. I will try to improve my behaviour and not to raise the hands and try to control a little bit more, because I haven't liked the experience. Although maybe they don't need me so much, you know, they did very well.
Dominic Solanke has been in scintillating form with 12 goals, and if he can continue finding the net, a potential top half push could be a real possibility on the south coast.
A hat-trick from Bournemouth's main man.
Which is a place that Wolves manager Gary O'Neill knows all too well, after keeping Bournemouth up last season, before moving north to the Midlands, where he is doing a fine job. The festive period went very well for O'Neill and his team, with 3 wins on the spin. A solid win against Chelsea was followed by a dominant 4-1 victory away at Brentford, a game in which Hwang Hee-chan scored twice to take his tally for the season to 10.
Hwang, and still, and takes it beautifully!
Their final game of the year saw another win and the return of star man Pedro Neto, whilst also being an emotional tribute to Mario Lemina, whose father sadly passed away the week before.
Hopefully today's result and seeing how much the boys think of him gives him a small lift in what is a really difficult time for him. So I've spoken to him a little bit the last day or so, and he understands he has as long as he needs to get himself where he needs to be to come back and help us again. And until that moment, he has our full support. So I hope him and his family are well.
Wolves' last game was a rather, shall we say, quiet 0-0 draw with Brighton, but it did mark the 633rd Premier League appearance for James Milner, putting him in outright second place in history. Generally, Albion have had another very good campaign under Roberto De Zerbi. They're unbeaten in their last 9 games at the Amex Stadium, which equals their longest ever run without defeat in top flight home matches.
Oh, what a way to come back!
Jack Hinchelwood's opener in the 4-2 win against Spurs was their 19th goal by a teenager in 2023. Only Liverpool provided more Premier League goals by teenage players in a single calendar year. There's no doubting that Brighton are firmly in contention for a second successive European spot. Let's just hope that their end of season celebrations are a tad better than this. Over in the red half of Manchester, a lack of goals has been a big factor in United's inconsistency. Only 3 teams in the Premier League have scored fewer. However, big money signing Rasmus Højlund scored his first goal for the club in a sensational comeback victory against Aston Villa.
Look at what it means!
I've had several talks with him, and every time I pointed out, hey, you scored for Denmark a lot. You scored in the Champions League, so there's demonstrated ability. So you can do it. So believe in it, and it will come. And I'm sure now the first goal's in, he will net more.
And then he went on to add another in his next game in the 2-2 draw against Spurs. Whilst the lack of goals is a worry, in defence they've been relatively strong. Andre Onana has the second most clean sheets in the league, and youngster Kobbie Mainoo has shown signs of great promise in the middle of the park. Just 1 point behind United are Chelsea, who are slowly creeping into contention for the top 6. It's been a very topsy-turvy campaign for the Blues, with forwards not always putting away their chances. But they have managed 3 wins on the bounce for the first time this season after penalty king Cole Palmer bagged the winner against Fulham. Palmer has been in sensational form all season, with his 9 goals and 4 assists putting him top of the overall charts for midfielders.
He's provided the team good things and helped, you know, to achieve the 3 points today that we needed, the 3 points to be in a better position on the table, no?
Newcastle had a difficult time over Christmas, and despite taking the lead against Manchester City, their 3-2 defeat means they're now on a 4-game losing run.
And Isak is in, with Walker to beat still, and Isak!
Injuries and suspensions to key players have not helped Eddie Howe and his squad, but it has meant teenager Lewis Miley has had a chance to shine.
Miley, tough to pick out!
His goal in the 3-0 victory against Fulham, their only win in the last 7, meant he became the club's youngest ever scorer in Premier League history and the 8th youngest of all time. Fulham's Christmas period had highs and lows with defeats to Bournemouth and Burnley, but they bounced back with a stunning 2-1 win at home to Arsenal.
And in he goes from Raul Jimenez.
Trying to make a run in towards the near post, it was Polina that met it.
A victory their fans clearly enjoyed. Raul Jimenez has returned to form with 5 goals in his last 8, and Marco Silva will need his main striker to keep firing if the Cottagers are to cement a mid-table finish.
Brilliant!
Silva's old club Everton has slipped closer to the relegation zone in recent weeks after a run of 4 matches without a win. Sean Dyche's Toffees had lost only once in 8 matches before their dip in form, a purple patch that included a 2-0 win over his former club Burnley.
And there again, it was Keane with a shot, and he's there to haunt his old home.
Jordan Pickford and the Everton defence will be crucial if they're to avoid the drop. They currently have the joint most clean sheets in the Premier League.
I know we get carried away sometimes on great goalkeeping saves, but that double save just now was fantastic.
Another team who have struggled in the latter part of this first half of the season is Brentford. With key man Brian Mbeumo absent through injury, goals are proving tough to come by. But keen Lewis Potter did grab his first for the club in the defeat to Aston Villa and followed it up with another against Crystal Palace. However, Ivan Toney's return to the side against Nottingham Forest has given the Bees a huge boost.
Welcome back!
The 3-2 win was their first since early December after a run of five defeats in a row. Crystal Palace have also been struggling to find the net. Their 22 goals is the third lowest in the division. However, they have had some positive results in December, including a memorable comeback from 2-0 down to draw at Manchester City, with much of the thanks going to Dean Henderson in goal. It was the fifth time in their last seven visits to the Etihad Stadium when they've come away with at least a point. We're pretty sure Roy enjoyed that one. A 3-1 win against Brentford to end the year also marked just the fourth time that the talismanic duo Michael Olise and Eberechi Eze have started a match together, which will give Roy Hodgson a serious boost in the second half of the season. Nottingham Forest have seen a mini upturn in form under new manager Nuno Espirito Santo after securing back-to-back wins for the first time since January 2023. The stunning Chris Wood hat-trick sank his old club Newcastle.
He's hat-trick hunting here, Chris Wood. That is beautiful!
Before Forest beat Man United for the first time since 1994 at a buoyant City ground.
And it is Gibbs White! And Forest are back in the lead!
The only other team in the league who have changed managers since the start of the season is Sheffield United. Chris Wilder's return to the club hasn't yet changed their fortunes, however, with just one win in seven. A 1-0 victory against Brentford. However, a debut goal from Ben Brereton-Diaz,
Premier League debut goal!
And the latest ever goal in Premier League history from Ollie McBurney, rescued a point against West Ham, which will give the fans some hope in the battle to avoid relegation. Sheffield United suffered defeat to Luton on Boxing Day and the Hatters are currently the promoted team closest to safety. Two late own goals saw the game swing in the Hatters' favour and was their second win in a row, after what was an emotional victory against Newcastle the week before. It marked the first game since club captain Tom Lockyer suffered a cardiac arrest against Bournemouth.
Rob Edwards in tears.
Their dramatic late equaliser at Burnley means Luton are just one point behind 17th placed Everton. That draw meant Burnley are still 4 points behind Luton, and the Clarets have a challenging run of fixtures in the coming weeks.
Cooper, and it's there!
Vincent Kompany's men did have a positive result over Christmas, however, beating Fulham 2-0, which included a wonder goal from Wilson Odobert.
That will do it for Burnley!
Liverpool topped the table after only one defeat all season, with Man City, Arsenal and Aston Villa hot on their heels, just 5 points behind. Spurs remain in fifth and have a 5-point gap to West Ham. Brighton, Man United, Chelsea and Newcastle round out the top 10, with Wolves slightly edged out only on goal difference. Remarkably, there is only a gap of 5 points from Bournemouth in 12th, all the way down to Forest in 16th, who have a 3-point cushion over Everton.